We are now just a couple of hours out from the dawn service, and about 1,500 people have settled in and they're waiting. But they arrived to very unsettling news that Turkish police had arrested a 26-year-old Syrian national by the name of Abdul Karim Halif, an Islamic State supporter who they say was planning some sort of a bomb or vehicle attack at this dawn service in retaliation for the Christchurch terror attack. So you can imagine the chills that that sent along this peninsula. He was taken into custody in a town only about 2 hours' drive from here, and security is unprecedented tonight. The people here were kept waiting buses for several hours, very, very thorough security checkpoints, bag searches, full body searches in some cases, and no one is complaining.
I guess it's reassuring to know that they are doing things to catch people, and like we know that there's so much security here that we don't feel unsafe or anything like that.
You can only be as scared as the young fellas were when they hopped off the boat, eh? So I was going to come, I'm coming.
This is deeply concerning. I'd urge Australians who have family overseas, and indeed Australians travelling overseas, to please check with the Department of Foreign Affairs Trade Travel Advisory. It's currently advising a high level of caution for people there.
Now, the service is going ahead as planned. Australian authorities say they are liaising with the Turkish authorities, but there is no change to the plan or the preparations for this commemoration. The only change, really, I would say, is a shift in the mood. This is a lifetime pilgrimage for many people. This year commemorates 104 years since the Allies landed here on Anzac Cove. So it has somewhat overshadowed that, but I think the intense security is very comforting. We were here much earlier and witnessed dozens of snipers heading up into the cliffs and the ridges overlooking Anzac Cove, standing where their Turkish ancestors would have stood, looking down and watching the Allies landing. So it is all very eerie, but the crowds here very much trying to focus on those Anzac and Australian values rather than this terror threat as we wait for the service to begin.